Hey, boys and girls, Mike here, one go ShortPlay, one more for tonight, one more for the road. This is called Apha Mission on the NES. It's getting on for 11 o'clock, so I suppose I better go to bed, given that I've got to be up for 9. It's a top-down shooter, okay. You know where we stand with a top-down shooter? That was cool. Ah, so we've got bombs and lasers. Lasers that don't seem to hit a thing. Oh, I see, the bombs do that. Oh, the bombs don't hit. One of them seems to hit stuff, one of them does. Okay. This is very difficult to actually make these things connect. Ow. Very fast moving enemies, very slow moving player. And that doesn't seem to make sense, because unless you know exactly where they're going, you can't really do much about them. That said, I imagine after a few goes, you probably do get to know where they're going. And let's face it, they're not really aiming for me. They're just going into random patterns. It's not a very pretty game. I mean, everything seems boxy and blocky, predictably. Because that's how the attribute works, isn't it? The color attribute. That's what I wanted, an S. I thought I might get one eventually. So, as you can see, two types of weapons. We've got our lasers, we've got our missiles. And the lasers hit spaceships, the missiles hit stuff on the floor on that. Oh! I don't like the collision detection on those. That's the second time that's happened. I got really close to picking something up and actually connected with it, but didn't connect with it because I didn't connect with the middle sort of square of it, 8x8 square of it, you know. That doesn't seem very fair. It's a little annoying. Oh, and the weapon's down to nothing again, which means it's game over when you lose your first life. And I hate that about shooters. It's put me onto a harder bit of the level, but it's taking the weapons away. Where's the fairness in that? Why does every shooter insist on doing that? There's got to be a reason why they always go, no, we've got to take the weapons off and now we've lost the life. That's the rules. Why is that the rules? As those of you who know about my little game dev efforts know, my shooter doesn't do that, and it's a better game for it, I think, than it would have been if it did the whole steal your weapons on your life. It's just a stupid rule, it doesn't need to be in place, and it ruins many a good game, and many a potentially good game. Apidia, I'm looking at you, I love that game, it was brilliant, it had such potential, and then I lost a life, and I could not get any further, and I realised basically you've got to learn to beat the game on one life. I think it harks back to when the coin op machines were trying to get more money out of you. I can't put my finger on why that is. Oh, that was a disappointment. I'm ending the night on a disappointment. Apha Mission for the NES, didn't like it. Kind of liked it until the baddies proved to be a bit too fast to actually fairly play against. And then liked it a bit less. And then liked it fair. more or less. It's late, I'm tired. Lost a bit more respect for it when I lost my weapon on losing life. I don't know, I suppose if you get good at it, it could be good, and let's face it, when kids bought these games, this is going to be a demo now, they would invest time because they'd already invested, I don't know, 20 quid of cash into the cart. I won't be doing that, incidentally, with this one. As you know from my other videos, I'm looking at games that I might buy for my NES when I can afford to. This isn't one of them. Bit of a shame, because I got a bit excited about this top-down shooter thing. Anyway. Apha Mission for the NES. Thanks for watching.